A new study reveals cash usage in the Philippines last year fell, indicating a shift to mobile wallets in a country where cash has always been king. Our correspondent Andrea Taguines monitored that study by digital payments company Visa, and she filed this report.
Payments via mobile wallets now at par with cash transactions in the Philippines. That's according to Visa's latest Consumer Payment Attitude Survey, which saw cash usage in the Philippines falling to 87% in 2023 from 96% in 2022. Mobile wallet usage also came in at 87%, with majority usually going for the QR code option. For Visa Country Manager for the Philippines, Jeff Navarro, this is proof that the cashless wave continues to gain momentum in the country, long after the lifting of COVID-19 lockdowns.
The momentum for attempting to go cashless has remained to be strong, and the confidence year on year has been increasing. In the past, there used to be a big disparity between cash, mobile, and cards. But what we've seen now is mobile payments now is more or less synonymous to the same way as 87% of cash.
Based on the study, 43% said they carried less cash in their wallets in 2023 compared to the previous year. It also found that 83% of Filipino consumers, led by the younger and affluent segments, even attempted to live without cash and were able to manage for an average of 10 days. Navarro attributed this growing confidence to go cashless to the increase in the number of establishments accepting digital payments.
Compared to last year, have you seen an increase in the number of merchants that support mobile wallets? 87% said yes. 63% also saw visibly an increase in card acceptance through swiping, and 52% believe and saw that it also increased for contactless. So dun nanggagaling yung level of confidence on why they now are okay to say yes, I can survive without cash.
Supermarkets, food and dining, and bill payments were the leading merchant categories that consumers observed to have opened up acceptance of cashless payment methods. Catherine Cabaleo is among those who use an e-wallet to pay for groceries and utility bills.
Convenient kasi hindi ka na pupunta mismo sa Meralco, hindi ka na mismo pupunta sa Maynila. Save siya kapag wala kang dalang cash.
Moving forward, the Visa study also showed that 1 in 3 consumers see the Philippines becoming a cashless society by 2030. However, Navarro also acknowledged that internet connection is still a big problem in some areas in the country. That's why he said Visa is also looking at possible ways to facilitate offline cashless payments.
We're trying to work with some of our issuers and acquirers to see if we can do something that's offline. But these are very early discussions. There's still no concrete solution. But it's really one of those that we want to do because it again supports the national agenda of the government for financial inclusion.
He said they plan to be able to pilot a program this year, if not early next year. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine government's budget shortfall in 2023 shrinking by 6.3% to 1.5 trillion pesos. That's compared to 1.6 in the previous year. The Philippine Treasury Bureau points to the growth in revenues outpacing overall state spending for the period. Although that figure is still higher than the government's estimate for a 1.49 trillion pesos shortfall penciled in December last year. The agency says the deficit when measured against GDP eased to 6.2% last year from the record 7.3% in 2022. Again, that is still above the 6.1% target of the Cabinet-level Development Budget Coordination Committee. The Philippine Central Bank expects inflation in February to either stay steady or to pick up, falling within the 2.8% to 3.6% range. The figures are well within government's target of 2 to 4%. Inflation for January, remember, came in at just 2.8%, the lowest since October 2020. The central bank says inflation could be driven up by higher prices of rice, meat, and fish, along with recent hikes in fuel and power costs. But these could be offset by lower prices of fruits and sugar. The Philippine Statistics Authority will release the official inflation print for February next Tuesday, March 5th. A group warns wage increases in 2023 alone led to over 20,000 job cuts. But a think tank thinks otherwise, saying the move will only be a small sacrifice for businesses. Zen Hernandez reports.
For ordinary workers, a legislated wage hike will provide much needed relief.
Talagang 350. Kumbaga, yun na yung siguro pang ano, bilang pangkain ko na araw-araw. So bali yung 16 na minimum na sahod, hindi ko na babawasan.
But for employers, it means catastrophic implications on jobs and inflation. Ibon Foundation, on the other hand, claims employee compensation is less than 11% of total business expenses, and a wage hike need not be inflationary if enterprises will sacrifice a small portion of its profits. But labor-intensive industries such as export and manufacturing is an entirely different story. According to the Confederation of Wearable Exporters of the Philippines, or CONWEP, up to 35% of manufacturing costs is from labor. Investors are also primarily foreign, and many have pulled out during previous wage hike adjustments that resulted to 23,200 job losses in 2023 alone.
Very alarming, nakakatakot yon. Kasi 30 to 50 pesos pa lang ang in-increase namin last year. Hindi na kinaya. Kasi nga, 2022, meron ding 31 to 56 pesos na increase. Two consecutive eh. Dalawang magkasunod na taon.
CONWEP expects the trend to continue this year and projects further job losses of up to 21,000 even without a new wage increase. In fact, CONWEP says two major investors have already expressed plans to move to other countries this early.
Hindi na namin talaga kaya. Tandaan mo, meron silang sister company sa Vietnam. May sister company sila sa Cambodia. May sister company sila sa Bangladesh. Meron din yung mga ganyan. Ano yung mga investor na to? Ang daling i-pull out yan.
CONWEP is appealing for a two-year moratorium on wage adjustments to allow the industry to recover. Aside from local issues, the industry is also facing challenges caused by crises overseas, including the war in Ukraine and the conflict in the Middle East. The group, however, also recognizes the plight of its workers and have written a letter to President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., Congress, and the Trade and Labor Departments to intervene and provide a monthly 1,000 peso inflation subsidy for the next 2 years, similar to the COVID Adjustment Measures Program provided during the pandemic. The Labor Department says it is open to suggestions, but also clarified that its budget for the said program is intended for trainings and assistance to displaced workers. Government resources must also be taken into consideration.
Hindi naman ganun kalaki ang kanyang ang pondo o budget para diyan, Sen. Ang natatandaan ko, more or less, mga 500 million. We have to be very prudent. Pwede kaming maging bukas for as long as we have the legal basis to more or less do it. No? O hindi man siya buwanan, pwedeng siguro quarterly or once in 6 months, makatulong.
Laguesma assured, however, that the government's economic cluster is already discussing possible aid options in the midst of rising prices of commodities. The House Committee on Labor and Employment is also studying the feasibility of subsidies. Zen Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.
The Federation of Filipino-Chinese Chambers of Commerce and Industry Incorporated warns the proposed 100 peso legislated wage hike will not just hurt businesses, but also consumers amid possible price increases. The group clarifies, though, it is not against raising the salary of minimum wage earners.
Wag naman ngayon, di ba? This is the opportunity for us to stabilize, to hold whatever is needed for us to move forward. Sana, pag-usapan muna natin kung anong maganda. Sabi ko nga kanina, we are not against wage hike increase principally. Kailangan natin yan, wage hike, para sa mga minimum wage earners. But we prefer it to be discussed in the tripartite committee or organization.
Meanwhile, the business group also sounding the alarm on the possible increase in PhilHealth contribution alongside the wage hike.
Global warming ngayon eh. May minimum wage, tapos may PhilHealth sabay-sabay. Pero yung PhilHealth natin, balita ko, nahihirapan na sila sa sa current contribution. Huwag sabay-sabay, lalo mahihirapan yung employers, lalo mahihirapan yung business, eh, lalong may incentive for them to increase prices.
Speaking of Filipinos and Chinese, a friendship arc symbolizing ties of Manila and Beijing set to be built in Malabon City. The FFCCCI will also sponsor the construction of the arc in the city. Other Filipino-Chinese friendship arches in the country can also be found in Manila, Quezon City, Davao, and Baguio. A mixed movement in oil prices seen in the first full week of March. The Philippine Energy Department expects gasoline prices to increase by as much as 45 centavos per liter, while a liter of kerosene and diesel expected to go down by 30 to 60 centavos per liter.